Hey guys, good morning. This is Jyoti Dogra. Welcome back to my channel. And I'm doing a pick a card reading today. Usually I do a mid-month tarot spread, but today I'm doing a pick a card reading. And this reading is about what is coming towards you in love in 2019. Because we are almost at the end of 2018 and we will be entering 2019 soon. So many of you would be wondering if you would come across somebody in love and what kind of person that will be, what could be the possible profession. So all of these questions are going to be answered in this particular tarot spread. Okay, and you can also match if that personality matches with any of your exes, so that it can tell you if your ex is coming back to you in 2019. Okay, so we have four piles to choose from. This is pile number one, pile number one, pile number two, three, and four. Please take a moment and meditate and see which one calls out for you. Sometimes the pile that you does not like is the one for you. Sometimes, okay. And you can just pause it for a moment if you want to, and then we will start. So I'm telling again, this is pile number 1, 2, 3, and 4. Also, if you want to book a personalized paid reading with me for tarot, palmistry, or astrology, that is Vedic astrology, your birth chart analysis, you can connect for the same with me on the links mentioned in the description box below. I provide paid consultations for the same on my Facebook and Instagram. Okay, I think you got enough time to start, you know, to pick a pile. So let me start with the pile number one. Let me keep it here. So this is pile number one, and we have, let me show you the cards, the Death and the Queen of Wands. Now don't get scared seeing the Death card, because I will be telling you the type of personality that person will be having and what could be the possible profession. So with this Death card here, okay, with the Death card here, this denotes that this person is going through a transformation in their life. Okay, this is someone who is going through a transformation, a very big shift in their life. Okay, they might be going through it now, and then they will be meeting you in 2019. Okay, so that is possible, or maybe they have gone through that transformation and now they are healing. Okay, some kind of healing is going on here, some kind of loss has happened to them. Okay, they are experiencing a transformation. Okay, and with this card, it also shows there could be some issues with money. So either their money is stuck with somebody, or you know, some, they have to give money to someone and they are not having enough funds. So even that is possible here. Okay, and they might be, you know, getting some inheritance, and you know, that is stuck somewhere. Even that is possible with this card here. Okay, and you know, this person, the person that is denoted by the Death card in tarot, is somebody who is drawn towards dark and adventurous things in life. Okay, they are not somebody who is very usual, that you meet every other day. Not that kind of a person. This is someone who is very unusual, very odd kind of a person. Okay, and but they are very interesting also, because you know, you just come across such people very rarely in your life. Okay, so they are somebody who is drawn to dark and adventurous things, a very odd person but very interesting at the same time. Okay, and they could also be somebody who is very good at keeping secrets, and they themselves are a very secretive person. Okay, and they are somebody who love excitement and who love experiencing different things, and they take a lot of pride in their personality. So they are very proud of who they are. Okay, they are not somebody who lacks confidence, no, because they have had this you know, moment, and they are having this transformation. So they take a lot of pride in what they are now. Okay, and they are a very changed person. Okay, this could be someone from the past as well who's now completely changed, so that could be there. Okay, and you know, their friend circle is also very unusual, because they are very unusual. They attract such people. Their friend circle is very unusual people, very different kind of people. Okay, and you know, they are very secretive. They are very secretive, and they are very good at keeping secrets of others as well. Okay, and you know, sometimes because of all these things, they could be a loner at heart. Okay, so they are someone who's a very loner at heart kind of a person. The zodiac that comes with it is Scorpio, and you know, Scorpios are very sensual people, very emotional, but they don't exhibit their emotions to others, and they are loners at heart, I tell you. And I love scorpions. I mean, I'm a Gemini and I love scorpions, like amazing people. I would definitely want to date a scorpion again. Okay, and the career they could be in, the career could be something related to Queen of Wands. That could be, they could be an entertainer, they could be an actor, an actress, okay, somebody who's a motivational speaker because she's very confident, who is a business owner, okay, very business minded, very business owner kind, a business owner, okay, business minded person, somebody who is a motivational speaker. In general also, not everybody can be a motivational speaker at a higher level. Maybe they motivate people in their lives, okay, they are someone who's very motivating and people go to them for motivation, so that is possible, okay. They could be in HR, that is human resource management, okay. They could be having their own restaurant, maybe, because I said they could have their own business, okay. Hotel management is possible with this, sports is possible with this, they could be in sports, they could be a commentator, they could be a journalist, a radio jockey, all of that is also possible. They could be a writer also, because she's very creative, and could be a traveler, okay, someone who travels a lot, maybe a travel blogger. Yeah, so all these professions come with this, okay. Now pile number two. So we have Two of Wands and Page of Pentacles. Oh my god, nice. So we have Two of Wands as the kind of person they are, and Page of Pentacles for the profession they could be in, okay. Let me just move it here and put this card here so that you can see, okay. Yes, this is better, okay. So, you know, Page of Wands as a person is someone who's very assertive, okay. They are very direct, they won't beat around the bush, okay. They are very good with money, they could be in real estate as well, okay. Yeah, by the way, this, I'm so sorry, I did not say. So yeah, the signs could be Scorpio in this one and all the fire signs, okay. Yeah, pile number two. Yeah, so this person is someone who's very direct, very self-assertive, okay. Someone who's very good with money, they are very brave and they are very valiant in their endeavors, okay. This is someone who can take risks, okay, in career or in life. This is somebody who can take a risk, okay. And this is somebody to whom business comes very naturally to them, okay. And they are like an entrepreneur. Even if they are not, they will have that kind of mindset. They are an entrepreneur, they are a leader, okay, whom people follow very willingly, okay. This is not somebody who makes others follow them forcibly. No, this is somebody whom people follow willingly, okay. And there is also a very good possibility that this person is from different background, different ethnicity, could be a foreigner as well for some of you, because Two of Wands shows a travel and, you know, someone who's from a different ethnicity or background than yours, okay. And or they could be having a business which deals with foreign things, okay. So that is also possible. This person definitely has a connection with foreign land, foreign places, okay. Yeah, so that kind of a person who travels a lot, maybe they travel a lot to foreign places. And then as the profession, we have the Page of Pentacles, and they could be an intern, they could be a student, they could be dealing with profession, you know, related to horse, okay. And they could be in banking kind of profession, finance related profession, because Pentacles here shows that. They could be in, at an entry level job, they could be a nature guide, okay. They could be a ranger, could be a librarian, could be a vet or an intern in some company, yeah. And the signs that I see are fire signs and the earth signs, okay. This person could also have Mars in Aries, could be in real estate as well, okay. The next pile that we have, the third pile, we have the World card and the King of Cups. So with World card, this person is very confident and very wise, okay. So with World card, this person is very confident, they are very wise, okay, and they are worldly, means they are having contacts with people of different background, different state, different country, means they have a network circle which is spread, okay, which is widespread network circle, okay. And they are somebody who is with substance. They don't talk crap, okay. When they talk, they have some substance in their speech, okay. And they are somebody who's not afraid to put efforts, okay. And they are somebody who is again willing to take a risk, okay. And they could be somebody who is into teaching or training kind of profession, okay. Someone who is very confident and in all the situations, they are very confident kind of person. They are very they are having a lot of substance in them, okay. And their positive skills and attitude can also take them to travel a lot. So this might be a person who travels a lot and might be going overseas to teach or to train people, okay. And they just love to learn, okay, because with World Card a lot of education comes into play. So they are someone who's very learned and they love to learn new things, learn new skills, okay. And they just keep reading because that what makes them alive, okay. And they are very well educated and have plenty of practical knowledge also. So they are very practical, very educated kind of person, okay. And at workplace they are very relied, so people rely on them at workplace. So they are at some good position in the career as well, okay. And for the professions, this could be a photographer, okay. They could be a father, okay. Like for some of you, it could be a married man who is having kids and he is looking after them. So that's why a lot of responsibility comes in. He's very responsible, as I said. So he could be a father who is taking care of his children, maybe. Could be a teacher, could be an artist, could be an actor, okay. Could be a marine, could be in marine related professions. Could be a sailor, okay. Could be what, like marine related profession, anything. Could be a counselor, could be a psychologist, therapist, educator, any creative field, or could be an artist, a zoologist, okay, marine biologist, could be a shaman, could be a healer, okay, could be in medical or could be a vet, okay. So all of these. So that was your reading pile number 3. And for the signs, it could be a water sign, okay. Finally, we have the pile number 4. So we have the King of Swords and Nine of Cups here. Okay, so King of Swords is someone who is very rational, who is very ethical person, okay. And he is somebody who mentors others, okay, and others learn from him. And they are very expert kind of people, okay. And they are somebody who are expert at things, but they don't flaunt their knowledge because they don't have to. People anyway respect them, okay. They are very successful and very confident people, okay. And for them, their reputation is very, very important. This is somebody who is very image conscious, okay. And what can I say? They are very educated, and because they are so educated, very well respected. So they are having a, you know, very good job in which people respect them. They could be in an authoritative position in career, okay. And this is somebody who makes very good decisions and who is a very good debater. And when they debate, they know what they're speaking, okay. This is not somebody who will be speaking crash and then losing a debate. No, when they debate with you, they know what they're speaking. They speak on facts, okay. They don't speak on stories. So that kind of a person, okay. And for the profession, it is Nine of Cups. So this person could be somebody who is in the public eye, so profession which deals with a lot of people on a daily basis. That person, somebody who is having a creative job, because Nine of Cups comes with creativity as well. This could be in